Thank you. Yeah, just stay here until they're done, then you'll put them all back on there. Off into that corner.
Everybody knows that high school sports generate suspense, excitement, and drama.
They also generate higher grade point averages, stronger work habits, and greater self-esteem.
Everybody knows that high school sports give us more value for our entertainment dollar.
They also give us leaders committed to strengthening communities right here in Missouri. The true value of playing sports in school can't be measured in minutes of losses or dollars and cents. Studies show that participation in sports, along with other extracurricular activities, is one of the best ways to teach leadership, cooperation, accountability, and other invaluable life skills. Don't just stand on the sidelines. Encourage the young people you know to get in the game. When you do, you'll be helping them get ahead in life. High school sports, a winning part of a complete education. This message presented by the Missouri State High School Activities Association and the Missouri Interscholastic Athletic Administrators Association.
The heart and soul of Missouri's high school and junior high athletic contest. Officials, keeping the games fair, giving back to high school sports, making a difference. The 750 mission member schools and more than 300,000 high school and junior high school athletes salute Missouri's contest officials. Register to become a high school official today. Mission, take a chance and make a difference.
Thank you. Thank you.
required textbook, but it's filled with valuable lessons. It may not take place in the classroom, but it's an ideal environment for learning. It may not involve a diploma, but it can help prepare Missouri's young people for life. It's high school sports. High school sports can play a critical role in students' overall education. In fact, studies show that students that participate in high school sports are more likely to enjoy greater levels of achievement in their academic lives. If you think high school sports are only about competition, think again. Better yet, think about attending a high school sporting event in your community. You'll be amazed by what you see. High school sports, a winning part of a complete education. This message presented by the Missouri State High School Activities Association and the Missouri Interscholastic Athletic Administrators Association.
Courtside to introduce the team hosts for today's game. The team host for the Jaguars is Paulette Thurston. The team hosts for the Red Knights are Carl and Charlotte Hurst. The team hosts serve as assistants to the team, helping them enjoy their stay in Columbia. Please join us in thanking them for their time and support. Starting lineups. First, for Incarnate Word, number two, a sophomore, 5 feet, 4 inches, Nikita Bell. For Fort Zumwalt West, number one, a senior at 5 feet 9 inches, Kelsey Kingsborough. For the Red Knights, number 22, a senior at 5 feet 4 inches, Leticia DeLoach. For the Jaguars, number 3, a senior at 6 feet 2 inches, Marina Larrity. For the Cardinals, number 24, a senior at 5 feet 7 inches, Sierra Young. For the Zumwalt West, number 10, a senior at 5 feet 7 inches, Paige Westbrook. For the Red Knights, number 44, a sophomore at 5 feet 9 inches, Quinn Adams. For the Jaguars, number 11, a senior at 5 feet 8 inches, Kylie Allison. And for hard work, number 50, a senior at 6 feet 3 inches, Taylor Manuel. And for Fort Zumwalt West, number 12, a junior at 5 feet 9 inches, Katie Hare. The officials for this game are Megan Matthews, Ronell Turner, and Kevin Harrison. These officials have been chosen to work the Show Me Showdown because of their experience and the quality work throughout the season. Join us in recognizing the hard work.
FS Midwest Prep Zone on your screen. I'm Jonah Javad, and welcome to Mizzou Arena. It's the Class 5 consolation game. Missouri State High School Activities Association. It's the state championship events, but this is for the third place. Yesterday we saw Incarnate Word fall to Rockridge by 3 points, and Fort Zumwalt West fell to Blue Springs. So Rockridge and Blue Springs headed to the Class 5 state championship. But here in the third place game, the Red Knights and the Jaguars, both hailing from St. Louis. And we've got a good one set for you in this one. Incarnate Word in red, Fort Zumwalt West in white. And it's the Red Knights who control the tip. Starting lineup on the floor for Incarnate Word, number 50, Taylor Manuel. You want to keep an eye on her. She gets going in a hurry, along with Nakia Bell, Sierra Young, Leticia DeLoach, and Gwen Adams. As for Fort Zumwalt West, controlling the ball right now is Paige Westbrook. Had a pretty good game in the semis. And Marina Laramie, number 3, also a player to look out for. Rest of the lineup on the floor for the Jaguars, number 1, Kelsey Kingsborough, number 11, Kylie Ellison, and number 12, Katie Hare. And it's Fort Zumwalt West getting on the board first. An early two shot made by Paige Westbrook. Inside, Manuel keeps the ball, no foul called, and shot good off the backboard. She has got the size to muscle her way in the low post and pretty much get anything she wants. Inside, Laramie double teamed. Nice find to Kingsborough. Shot does not fall, and Manuel clears the boards. Incarnate Word likes to come out and run. DeLoach. Top of the key to Adams. Good find inside. Manuel finds Adams. And shot good from Gwen Adams, her first two of the game. Incarnate Word had at one point a 15-point lead on Rockridge in the state semis, but the Bruins fought back in the second half and won by just 3 points. Taylor Manuel held quiet in that fourth quarter. That's a big reason why the Bruins were able to power through. But Manuel at least trying to get Incarnate Word a third place finish this season. And the Red Knights are 2-time defending state champs, and that will end here in 2012. But Incarnate Word also 4 third place finishes in the school's history. Fort Zumwalt West best finish was 4th place all time. So a win here would be the school's best finish in school history. Jump shot from Laramie, top of the key, rims out. And Leticia Deloach gets the rebound, pushes it up court. Manuel, the intended target, it comes to Nakia Bell. Deloach, back out to Adams. And Manuel, such a imposing force, likes to stand out at the top of the key to help set up the offense. Adams, the offensive rebound put back, falls for two. An early 4-point lead for Incarnate Word. Paige Westbrook splits the D. Wide open, Kelsey Kingsborough lays it in, and one. That play all set up by Westbrook, cutting up the defense, finds Kingsborough underneath the hoop to get the basket, plus the foul. Kingsborough had a slow game in the semis. An unconventional shot is what Kingsborough has, sort of a two-handed shot put. But good on the free throw now, just a one-point game. Driving is Nia Roth. A foul on the floor. Foul is on Kelsey Kingsborough. Inside, Manuel Laramie fell down and a left Manuel wide open down low. That's a great matchup to watch, Laramie and Manuel. Two bigger players, both will play at the next level in college. Both seniors playing in their last high school game. Laramie, what a move to finish. Back-to-back old-fashioned three-point plays for Fort Zumwalt West. And now the Jaguars a chance to tie this at eight. Laramie a bit quicker than Manuel. Spin move here, catches her off guard and lays it in. Manuel's first foul. Laramie will go to Indiana State next season. Taylor Manuel will also play D1 ball. She takes her talents to Purdue. Leticia Deloach sets up the offense. These Incarnate Word guards, 5'4", 5'4", and the one who's on the bench right now, Sierra Young, 5'7". Pretty short, but lots of speed and quickness, able to get around those screens, but also very good defensively. There's the steal, and now Incarnate Word looks to capitalize. Foul called on Kingsborough. A hold on Gwen Adams, who established position down low. Substitutions coming into the game now. Lexi Moe checks in for Fort Zumwalt West. Carly Frela, along with Sierra Young, come into the game for Incarnate Word. Manuel, great feed inside of Young. Roth drives, lost it, and got it back. Frela, over to Young. Sierra Young drives hard, and Kylie Ellison, good hands to strip it away. Jaguars now with a chance to take the lead. Laramie. We'll slow it up. Here's Lexi Moe. Katie Hare lost it, but a foul. Oh, excuse me, a travel call. The reach-in was after the travel. Fort Zumwalt West along with Blue Springs in that semifinal game. Both teams had a lot of trouble with turning the ball over. A lot of traveling calls. Manuel, Nakia Bell open for three, takes it, does not make it, offensive rebound for Frela. And she kicks it back out to Young. Manuel inside, good feed to Nakia Bell, it's blocked. Paige Westbrook the block. And Manuel, instead of setting up down low, stands up at the top of the key because she's such a big body, she can find the cutters. It's two times she's made great passes down low, but Incarnate Word unable to get any points out of them. Laramie the jump shot, not there. It will stay Jaguars basketball. Leticia Deloach comes into the game now, replacing Nakia Bell. Laramie for three, got it. Marina Laramie can really stretch the defense. And a great defensive play from Laramie to block it, saves it too. Katie Hare picks up her dribble and gets it over to Westbrook. Jaguars a 3-point lead over Incarnate Word. Laramie trying to seal position on Manuel. That's a tough thing to do. Westbrook the floater gets it to fall. Jaguars out to a 5-point lead. Incarnate Word, number two in the state. Fort Zumwalt West, number four. The Jaguars got stymied by Blue Springs in the semis because the Wildcats' defense of Blue Springs just too aggressive, getting in the passing lanes, and ultimately led to Fort Zumwalt West's demise. But now the Jaguars have a chance to get third place in the 2012 season. A record of 26-6 on the season for Fort Zumwalt West, 25-7 for Incarnate Word, and a foul is called. Paige Westbrook charged with a foul. Gwen Adams down low, flips it up, no good. And Laramie there to clear the boards. Six seconds to shoot. Inside, Ellison gets it off and does not fall. But at the end of one, Fort Zumwalt West, a 13-8 lead over Incarnate Word. A little bit improbable, but lots of basketball left to be played. Second quarter action coming your way from Mizzou Arena. Stay with us. Regardless of this finish, both team season will be over, but Fort Zumwalt West at least looking for its best finish in school history. It'd be a third place finish in the Class 5 state championships. And early on, a 5-point lead for the Jaguars over Incarnate Word. Marina Laramie really leading the way for Fort Zumwalt West. She has an early 6 points, 1-for-1 from beyond the arc, and also 3 rebounds. If she stays out of foul trouble, she can be quite a handful for the other team. Same goes for Taylor Manuel, number 50 of Incarnate Word. Manuel has 4 points, 2 boards, And she had a terrific first half against Rockbridge. But the Bruins able to come away with that victory as they head to the state championship for the first time since 08. Ellison's jump shot no good, and Laramie almost gets the rebound, but Ellison gets it herself. Laramie for three. Yes, sir. Marina Laramie is on all sorts of fire. Nine points for Marina Laramie. Inside, Gwen Adams with the left hand. And she takes a spill. Much more fluid basketball in this game. Kingsborough puts on the floor. Laramie working on Young. Ellison now. Laramie for three once again. No. That time it doesn't fall, but Hare the offensive rebound, and she has 2 points. Well, right place, right time for Katie Hare. She gets two. Laramie put up another three and just a bit off the mark. And crashing the boards is so important in basketball. It doesn't matter what level you play at. And now Fort Zumwalt West, an 8-point lead over Incarnate Word. Jaguars a very good team in their own right, but after yesterday, Blue Springs really just took it to Fort Zumwalt West, and Incarnate Word actually led most of the game against Rockbridge. You would think in this one the Red Knights would run away with it a little bit, but that is the opposite so far. Marina Laramie in the state semis game yesterday had three personal fouls in the first half, and that really limited her offensively as well as on the defensive end, couldn't be as aggressive, and Blue Springs took advantage. But now here in the consolation game, playing for third place, out to 9 points, 3 of 6 from the floor. Already out to a terrific start, and she's a player who scores over 16 points a game, as well as leading the team in rebounding with nearly 8. The Red Knights down 8. Look to get something going. Taylor Manuel really hasn't had the rock down low too much. Only 4 points for her. That's Manuel up top. Nakia Bell, a strong take, high off the glass, no good. And a jump ball as there's a scrum for the loose ball. Possession arrow points in the direction of the Red Knights. Manuel versus Laramie, that's the matchup we're looking for in this game. Both players guarding each other, a bit bigger than everybody else on the floor. Manuel almost makes a great find, throws it off the body of Ellison. Manuel so big, gets her rebounds, gets her points, but you wouldn't think it. 4.5 assists per game, that's real good for a high school center. There's some point guards in high school basketball that don't even get 3 assists per game. And Manuel also trying to feed Adams, but it's knocked away. Well, it looks like Adams just lost it, a turnover, and now Fort Zumwalt West can actually take a double-digit lead. Hare to Kingsborough. Shot good. The Jaguars, a 10-point lead over Incarnate Word. Coach Dan Rolfes of Incarnate Word taking the jacket off. He means business. And Manuel inside gets 2. That one looked pretty easy. Makes you wonder why they don't do that more often. Once again, a 2-on-1. Hare will shoot the jumper this time and drains it. Katie Hare, 2 for 2 from the floor, 4 points. Sierra Young, jump shot, nothing but nylon. Sierra Young, arguably the best jump shooter for the Red Knights, just a pure stroke. Nice play by Hare to save it, but Laramie lost it. Ball rolls out of bounds. It will go to the Red Knights. Young nearly willed Incarnate Ward back into the game against Rockbridge in the last couple minutes of the game. But the Bruins held on. And Incarnate Ward needs someone to get going. You would think it'd be Taylor Manuel. She just seems exasperated down low. Not exhausted, exasperated. You can see her face. There, Manuel, nice strong take and finishes. Manuel really conserves her energy offensively, doesn't run around a whole bunch, but when she gets that ball and she sees a lane, she takes off. And a nice finesse move to lay it in. 8 points for Manuel as she starts to get going. Laramie inside. Swings it to Hare. Hare back to Laramie. Now Kingsborough power dribble, lays it in. Kelsey Kingsborough had a rough one in the state semis, but 7 points for her. Shooting 75% from the field so far. 8 point lead for the Jaguars. Carly Fraila, wide open top of the key. Comes up a bit short. Ellison to Westbrook. Westbrook, great fight, and takes it all the way to the hoop. And I'll tell you what, Taylor Manuel's at the top of the key, guarding Laramie, which frees up that whole interior for point guards to drive into, and that's what Westbrook did. Fort Zumwalt West shooting 65% from the floor. Incredible. Kingsborough puts it on the deck. Tipped away by Manuel. And with a player like Taylor Manuel on the floor, Incarnate Ward can actually get a whole bunch of rebounds and block up that post, but Marina Laramie playing for Fort Zumwalt West, a bigger player who can shoot the three ball. Manuel has to guard her out on the three-point line, and that frees up that whole paint. And that has really led to Fort Zumwalt West success so far, a 10-point lead, and a timeout is called. 65% from the field for the Jaguars. And as you see, Marina sets the screen up top, and Manuel just standing out there. And that whole area underneath the basket wide open for Westbrook to drive. She has 6 points, 3 of 3 from the field. 8 second chance points as well for Fort Zumwalt West. And that often comes from just offensive rebounds, crashing the boards, and getting those easy buckets. Westbrook. Kingsborough over to Laramie now in the corner. Working on Fraila, gives it up after the double team. Kingsborough nearly traveled and gives it back out. This defense for Incarnate Word can be real smothering at times. And the Red Knights starting to turn it on a little bit. Down 10. Hare inside of Laramie. A travel. Nakia Bell on the wing. Deloach shoots from three. And just a bit off. Incarnate Word. 0 for 5 from beyond the arc. Hare has it taken away. No foul is called. A strong defense from the Red Knights. Now out in transition, Frela. Back out to Adams. Frela, good feet inside. Gwen Adams fouled. Incarnate Word so good at finding the open player down low, trying to get those high percentage shots. Adams will go to the free throw line. A little bit over a minute to go in the first half. Taylor Manuel will check into the game. And she replaces Carly Frela. Katie Hare comes out for Fort Zumwalt West. Lexi Moe comes in. Adams, a real good stroke for a power forward. Cuts the deficit to 8. Laramie up top. Swings it over to Westbrook, jumper. Rims out, and Manuel clears the boards. And now here comes Taylor Manuel showing off her dribbling skills. Oh, man. Good feet inside. Adams can't connect. Manuel really has the mind of a point guard, but in the body of a center. At the next level, you would figure she'd play probably the power forward position. 25 seconds left to go in the first half. Ball knocked out of bounds. It will stay Jaguars basketball. Westbrook drives, knocked away, Sierra Young. One-on-one on Kingsborough. And a foul, plus the basket. Silly defense on the part of Kelsey Kingsborough. Running backwards, not looking at Young out in transition. And Kingsborough just runs back and just throws up her hands. Young draws a contact and finishes. Kingsborough's either got to let her get that layup or foul. And I don't mean foul with her butt to the player. A silly foul with 15 seconds left to go in the first half. And that old-fashioned three-point play makes it a five-point game. Timeout called. Coach Monica Tritz of Fort Zumwalt West wants a talk it over real quick, 10 seconds left. Jaguars can get one last shot before halftime. But Fort Zumwalt West, a lot to be proud of, shooting 61%. But the 7 turnovers playing a key role. That was the Achilles heel for the Jaguars in the loss to Blue Springs yesterday, what knocked them out of the running for the state championship. But Incarnate Word still hasn't made a three-pointer. And the Red Knights staying strong. Gwen Adams and Taylor Manuel both 8 points. And only 3 players have scored for Incarnate Word. 7 seconds. 5. Westbrook's got to do something with it. Another timeout is called. At that point, it might not be worth taking the timeout. Just chuck it up.
This will be a 30-second timeout.
And Monica Tritz telling Westbrook, hey, look at the clock. Don't go and pigeonhole yourself out on the sideline. So now 2 seconds left. And you got to figure, The player to get the ball would be Marina Laramie in this situation. Inbounded to her and let her jack it up. Kylie Ellison will inbound. Laramie gets it, it's got to throw it up. Manuel knocks it away with half a second to go. The longest 10 seconds of first half I've ever seen. Unreal. Laramie inside, Westbrook, oh, it's just thrown away. Well, let's see, the referee is going to indicate there's a referees indicate Incarnate Word basketball, 0.5 left. So half a second for Incarnate Word to throw something up. The heave is out of bounds. Okay, now it's halftime for Zumwalt West. A 5-point lead over Incarnate Word. Marina Laramie, 9 points to lead all scorers. Second half action here at Mizzou Arena. Coming back in just a bit.
Farmers Insurance and Mission. The 2012 T-shirt tops. Cheerleaders from each school are now tossing shirts for previous championships this year. Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the floor as Jewel Thornton and Danielle George from Incarnate Word Academy and Haley Delgado and Tori Todd from Port Zumwalt West compete in Farmers Insurance around the world. The team that completes a layup, a free throw, followed by another layup, then makes it to the center logo first, wins. Let's cheer these contestants on. Congratulations to Jewel Thornton and Danielle George of Incarnate Word Academy on winning the Farmers Basketball and Farmers T-shirt. And also congratulations to Haley Delgado and Tori Todd of Fort Zumwalt West on winning a Mission Sportsmanship T-shirt. Congratulations and thanks to our contestants. Missouri State High School Activities Association would like to thank Boone County National Bank, Deep Rose Restaurant, and the Columbia Convention and Visitors Bureau for their support of this year's Show Me Showdown. Fans, you can keep track of all the results and scores from this year's championships on the official website of the Missouri State High School Activities Association by logging on to www.misha.org. You can see all the brackets, scores, and stats on the Show Me Showdown Information Central page. And keep up to date on all the news involving Missouri high school sports at the new Misha.org. Fans, don't miss the Class 4 and Class 5 Show Me Showdown Championship games only on FS Midwest. FSN is proud to be a partner with Misha and proud to bring you the 2012 Show Me Showdown Championship games on Saturday. Check the Misha website for channel information.
Thank you.
26-21, your score at the half for Zumwalt West on top of Incarnate Word here in the Class 5 State Championships. It's the consolation game between these two squads. Winner gets third place for the season. Rockbridge and Blue Springs will play on Saturday for the state championship. But a very good first half from the Jaguars of Fort Zumwalt West. 9 points from Marina Laramie, the senior, playing in her last game as a Jaguar. But Incarnate Word, a good strong finish to finish the first half. And inside, Gwen Adams gets 2 points, and that makes it a 3-point game. The Jaguars once led by 10 points, but the Red Knights, feisty defense has led them back, and now just a possession away from tying it. Kelsey Kingsborough power dribble and misses the shot. She loves that two-handed power step, but doesn't come up with the basket there, and a travel will give the ball back over to the Jaguars. Taylor Manuel, number 50 for Incarnate Word. 8 points in the first half, but really did it on a lot of solo takes to the basket. The post presence for the Red Knights has been Gwen Adams. 10 points, 4 of 6 from the field. 2 of those points coming from the stripe, but the other 8 all down low. Kingsborough, though, avenging that last possession with a jump shot. A nice touch to extend the lead back out to 5. Sierra Young, left-handed take, doesn't fall. Manuel, offensive rebound and put back. That's almost a gimme. Anytime Manuel gets the ball that close to the basket, it's good for 2. Laramie. Nice move around the basket, can't finish. The arms of Manuel got in the way, and now a foul called on Laramie. Manuel a little slow to get up. She actually took a hard spill in yesterday's game against Rockbridge over on the sideline. Took her a little while to recover, but Manuel walking it off. The Rockbridge Lady Bruins, who play on Saturday for the state title, in attendance for this one. When you can skip class, why not? Nikia Bell driving. Strong finish off the glass. Nikia Bell so quick and elusive, great at getting into the lane. And that time finishing off with a little kiss. Westbrook gets it off. Red Knights defense extremely pounding right now. The Jaguars really no answer for it. Got to shoot some jump shots because they can't get that ball down low. Laramie will try and do it herself. She's double teamed. Spin move. Shot comes up short. Manuel gets the rebound. Layup no good. Gwen Adams there to put it back in. Gwen Adams, 22 points. Excuse me, 12 points. 22 combined points between her and Manuel. Great day for the Incarnate Word front court. Westbrook jacks up the 3. Rims out. Manuel, the cross-court pass. Nia Roth walks. Not enough contact for a foul on that play by Roth. But the Red Knights, very diplomatic in this comeback, and now a 1-point lead over Fort Zumwalt West. Incarnate Word, a team that does not live and die by the 3-ball. 24 of the 29 points coming in the paint. The other 5 from the free throw line. Manuel takes it away. Incarnate Word with numbers. 4-on-2. Freyla finishes off the glass. But no, referee's waving it off in offensive foul. Nakia Bell is charged with the offensive foul. As you see, Westbrook just got her feet set in time, beating Bell to the spot. A big time stop for Fort Zumwalt West. That was to avoid going down by three. Laramie jumper, nothing but net. And Laramie's been a little quiet. Her first basket here in the second half. It's a three-pointer. But answering right back, Nakia Bell. An official timeout. And Nakia Bell being a little bit more aggressive offensively this half. And some people will say that's the worst shot in basketball, a foot inside the three-point line. But if you make it, you shut your mouth. It's a tie game here at Mizzou Arena, 31-31. Winner gets third place in the Class 5 state championships. Red Knights once down 10 points and have fought back. Almost the exact opposite of what we saw in the game against Rockbridge. Red Knights were up by 15 at one point. But the Bruins fought back, and let's see if Incarnate Word can do the same. A display of resilience, perhaps. But a foul on Taylor Manuel. Second personal foul. Both teams shooting a great field goal percentage. 48% for Incarnate Word, 54% for Fort Zumwalt West. Laramie gets the ball inside and it's taken away by Manuel once again. Up court pass, Sierra Young finishes with the right hand. Great pass from Taylor Manuel to get that ball up court. Westbrook scoots around the defenders. And Kylie Ellison tried to get that ball down low to Kingsboro, and she traveled. Turnovers plagued Fort Zumwalt West in the state semis against Blue Springs. And the turnovers, none too pleasant now. 12 turnovers for the Jaguars in this one, down two to Incarnate Word. And I reiterate, Fort Zumwalt West was up 10 at one point in this game, but that lead has slipped due in part mostly to the front court play and the points in the paint. Manuel, 10 points, 7 rebounds, but also making a great dish to Sierra Young to give the Red Knights the lead. Incarnate Word shooting 50% from the field and all high percentage shots. You've seen 5 3-pointers, none of them go in. But 5 for 25 on 2-point field goal attempts, an absolutely stellar percentage. And Fort Zumwalt West, a little bit on their heels so far in the second half. Marina Laramie, 12 points, 4 of 9 from the field, 3 for 4 from beyond the arc. Only one personal foul. Foul trouble stymied her production in the semifinal game against Blue Springs, but if she can get going once again, as she did in the first half, we could be in for a great finish here. Red Knights, a team that just doesn't go away, a reason they're ranked number 2 in the state. Nia Roth Good take, and it hit every piece of the rim, just didn't fall through the net. Laramie, good feed inside of Kingsborough, an easy two. Laramie and Manuel might be two of the better passing front court players in all of Missouri. Manuel down low, kicks it back out. Adams, a wide open shot from the elbow, doesn't fall. And Laramie's just going to push it up court. Laramie for three, fouled. And nearly got it to fall. She's smiling, one of the 4-point play. As you see, she just finds the open player down low. Having herself one heck of a game, and it doesn't really matter whether it's scoring points or dishing it off. Laramie just has to get involved offensively. When she has that ball in her hands, she draws attention, usually a double team. And that will free up her teammates. Laramie gives Fort Zumwalt West a 2-point lead. 14 points, 4 boards. And the day not done for her. Roth around the screen, jacks a 3. Rims out. That's 2 straight shots from Nia Roth that have just rimmed out. Kingsborough puts it on the floor. A tough shot. Manuel straight up with her arms. That's a clean block. Bell tries to go around Ellison. Forces her shot off. Not there. Put back no good from Sierra Young. Gwen Adams. The offensive rebound, and she's fouled. Incarnate Word, 26 points in the paint.
Checking in for the Red Knights, number 22, Leticia Deloche.
Just 2 field goals not made in the paint for the Red Knights. And a 1-point lead for the Jaguars as a whole. Round of substitutions come into the game. Lexi Moe replaces Kylie Ellison, Carly Freyla into the game for Incarnate Word. Westbrook will get it across the timeline. Kingsborough picks up her dribble, and now Westbrook once again. Laramie now, working on Manuel. And a foul underneath. Foul called on Carly Freyla. Just her first personal, but she'll come out. Gwen Adams replaces her. And Gwen Adams has had one heck of a game, 13 points, 5 boards on 5 of 8 shooting, but 3 personal fouls. Gotta be careful to stay out of foul trouble. Manuel the rebound and automatically looks up court. A great feel for the game. And as I mentioned, mentally, almost like a point guard out there. Westbrook up court to Laramie. And she has to slow it up a little bit. Waning moments of the third quarter, Westbrook tries to find somebody open. This perimeter defense from Incarnate Word has been stellar. Laramie has it swatted away by Manuel. Manuel's such an imposing figure. 10 points, 8 boards, and a couple dimes. Kingsborough is fouled. And that will be the fourth foul on Gwen Adams. Who has a team high 13 points, and she'll surely come out now. Dan Rolfes elected to keep her into the game for this last minute and a half. And she had three fouls, and she just picks up her fourth with about 30 seconds to go in the third quarter. So she'll see the bench for a little bit of time. Carly Freyla comes in for her. Kingsborough gives the Jaguars a three-point lead. Nieroth on the wing. 15 seconds to go in the third quarter. Red Knights will hold for the last shot. Nakia Bell now. Freyla inside. Manuel. No good. Put back is there. And that takes us to the end of the third quarter. Taylor Manuel exhausted. A long season, a long career, but she still has one more quarter left to play. And that action coming your way in just a bit. Hang with us. For all the seniors, one last quarter of basketball to play, wearing their high school jerseys. 37-36 your score. Fort Zumwalt West a one-point lead here in their consolation game, Class 5 girls state championships. Fort Zumwalt West best finish in school history was fourth place. A victory here will set some history. Incarnate Word has back-to-back state titles, four third-place finishes in school history. But Fort Zumwalt West just doesn't care. Three-point lead now. Katie Hare, the putback. Leticia Deloach, good jump shot from the elbow. Comes off that screen so quick and goes right up with it. The guard's so quick to get to the spot, it's just being 5'4 can sometimes plague them in terms of jump shots. Defense able to get hands in their face. And we should be in for a pretty good finish between these two squads out of St. Louis. Marina Laramie going to work. Hook shot. Oh, what a play. Marina Laramie fought for all of that one. And a timeout called by Dan Rolfes of Incarnate Word. Just a 60-second timeout. Marina Laramie, 16 points in this game. Taylor Manuel has 12. And a great battle between those two players. A bit of the same mold, bigger bodies with a high basketball IQ, and players who draw a lot of attention down low, and the ability to kick it out to the open teammates really make them real diamonds in this type of atmosphere. You don't see a lot of players like that on the high school level. Two of the better players in the state, for that matter. And those two just wanting to get one last W for their high school squads. As I mentioned, Laramie heading to Indiana State, Manuel heading to Purdue. There must be something about Indiana. 3-point lead for Fort Zumwalt West. Laramie 5 of 13 from the field. Not overly impressive, but she was in the first half. Hit three pointers. Doing it from down low and also on the perimeter. Bell now drives, kicks to Deloach. A long two for Manuel. A good play coming out of that timeout, freeing Manuel for a long shot. Just about 2 inches separated that shot from a three-pointer, which would have tied this game. Kingsboro, down low double team, has to kick it out. Westbrook, jumper, no. Katie Hare, the offensive rebound. And a tie-up for the ball, no jump ball called, no foul. And now Incarnate Word a chance to take the lead. Up court. Sierra Young. Fraila tried to get inside Emmanuel, and Emmanuel just knocked it back out to her. Bell can't connect from deep. Laramie there for her sixth rebound. Now coming out. Pushes that ball up court. And Taylor Manuel coming from right behind Katie Hare. Swats it. Bell. Good pass to Young. Who lays it off the glass? Picture perfect. Manuel coming from behind with the block. And Incarnate Word runs a terrific 2-1 fast break to take a 1-point lead. Kingsborough laying out on the floor. Look at this, Manuel just getting right in there. No teammates to warn her that she was coming in for the swat, and Young lays it in. Personal foul is called on Nakia Bell. Kelsey Kingsborough to the line. The southpaw, great touch on that free throw shot. A 59% free throw shooter on the season. But you wouldn't think of it here in this one. 15 points for her, 5 of 5 from the stripe. Bell, 3 ball. No good. Nakia Bell 0 for 5 from beyond the arc. Incarnate Word still has not made a 3-pointer all game. 0 for 9. Fort Zumwalt West can increase its lead here. Kingsboro. Over to Ellison, that's a three. Adams there to get the rebound. Incarnate Ward looks to push up court. Young to Manuel in transition, and it's knocked away. Great defensive play made by Kingsboro. Laramie, jumper doesn't fall, hit the back iron. And the chase for the rebound goes off a Jaguars player. we're going to have a close finish between these two. Playing for third place in the Missouri State Championships. Manuel drains the shot. And Incarnate Ward a 1-point lead. Laramie open. Can she finish? No. And no one there to rebound for the Jaguars. Incarnate Ward now out in transition. Young will slow it up. Bell around the screen, wide open lane. Can't finish. And the rebound to Kylie Ellison. That's a big miss. It remains a 1-point game. Timeout called by Monica Tritz. Fort Zumwalt West trails by one. This thing gonna come down to the wire for sure, but Nakia Bell, a point blank look at extending this to a 3-point lead, but cannot finish. And she's really had a rough go. 2 for 13 from the field. Just 4 points, and as I mentioned just moments ago, 0 for 5 from beyond the arc. Incarnate Ward very fortunate that Taylor Manuel has got it going here in the second half, or at least when she needed to, the fourth quarter. 16 points, 10 boards, 8 for 11 from the field. Incarnate Ward, 32 points in the paint. 4 for 5 from the free throw line. A very disciplined squad that takes high percentage baskets. Well, takes high percentage shots, but makes them most of the time. And now we've got just shy of 3 minutes left to play. The last hurrah for Marina Laramie, Taylor Manuel. And the Jaguars have had a tough time getting that ball down low with Gwen Adams and Manuel on the floor. Imposing figures in the low post. Very tough to establish position. Laramie will try and drive and has it swatted away once again. Laramie's success has really come from deep. 9 of her 16 points from beyond the arc. Adams inside Emmanuel. Lots of ball movement from Incarnate Ward. Under 2 minutes to play. Deloach drives. It does not fall. Another layup missed by the Red Knights. Fort Zumwalt West extremely fortunate on the last few possessions for some missed layups from Incarnate Ward. And those are good looks, they're just not falling. And an inbounds pass stolen by Westbrook. Jaguars can take the lead on this possession. Hare to Laramie. Spin move, can't finish off the glass and Manuel the rebound. Crowd getting into this one. Deloach driving on Kingsborough and dribbles it back out. Extreme patience on the part of Incarnate Ward. No need to force anything. And a timeout called by Dan Rolfus. Sierra Young checks into the game for the Red Knights. Just a quick substitution timeout. 1 minute. 4 seconds remaining. Great take. Manuel, can she finish? Yes! Plus the foul! A big time basket from Taylor Manuel. Taylor Manuel, 18 points, 12 rebounds, shooting 75%. And a free throw here would make it a two-possession game. Count it. And now Fort Zumwalt West will have to hurry and get some sort of look, either a quick two and foul or hit a three. Lexi Moe comes off the screen, inside of Laramie. Kicks it out. Can Ellison get to it in time? She does, but it's a jump ball. Possession arrow points. To Fort Zumwalt West. A collective sigh of relief from the Jaguars fans. At least another chance to get a basket on this possession. 36 seconds remaining. Westbrook picks up her dribble. Laramie. Referees call a foul. They'll talk it over. Was not an offensive foul. No feet were established. So a blocking foul sends Marina Laramie to the stripe, shooting 1-1. The front end of 1-1 is so important. And she gets the first, cool as a cucumber. ...69% free throw shooter on the season. 4-for-4 from the line today. Make it 5-for-5. Fort Zumwalt West is 10-for-10 from the free throw line. 5-for-5, Kelsey Kingsborough and Marina Laramie. Great games for those two, both seniors. Taylor Manuel gets the ball and she'll push it up court. And finally, a foul is called. Marina Laramie with the reach. And that foul with 21 seconds remaining.
Team foul number 6. Timeout for Zumwalt West. This will be a full 60
and a timeout called by Fort Zumwalt West. Incarnate Ward has a 2-point lead. Kelsey Kingsborough, 5 personal fouls. She's on the bench. And Marina Laramie, 3 personal shields. She's not in danger of fouling out anytime soon. But the Jaguars really need Incarnate Word to miss a free throw. Well, excuse me. Looks like that was the last foul to give on the part of Fort Zumwalt West. So we have an inbounds coming here. Six team fouls from Fort Zumwalt West. And maybe, just maybe, the Jaguars can catch a break on the inbounds pass. We saw a great one that came down to the wire between Connett Ward and Rockbridge in the state semis. The Bruins prevailed. And now Incarnate Ward a chance to at least grab third place in the state tournament. Nakia Belda inbounds, gets it to Manuel. Got a foul quick. And Paige Westbrook does the honors. So Manuel will go to the line shooting 1-1. Manuel shot 67% from the free throw line on the season. She's 1-of-1 from the stripe today. but none bigger than the two she's about to shoot, should she make the first. Biggest free throw of the day right here. All nylon. Lead back out to three. A two-possession game. Red Knights lead by four. Jaguars got to get something off. Laramie shoots the three. No good. Young the rebound. And a quick foul. 7 seconds remain, and that should be your ball game. Fort Zumwalt West at 1 point led by 10 points. But Incarnate Word, so diligent down low, 34 points in the paint. Didn't hit a three all game, 9 misses, but it did not matter. Taylor Manuel, 21 points. Gwen Adams, 13. And Katie Hare's last desperation does not fall as Incarnate Word grabs third place in the Class 5 state tournament after winning back-to-back state titles. Taylor Manuel's career as a Red Knight comes to a close. Marina Laramie, Kelsey Kingsborough combined for 33 points for Fort Zumwalt West as their careers come to a close as well. It was a great game here for Mizzou Arena, but we got more on deck. FS Midwest Prep Zone on your screen, and it will be all day. So stay with us. Next game coming up in just a bit.
Captains Haley Boswell and Morgan Tarver to get the Jaguars team captain.